Howdy, folks, and welcome once more to Let's Play The Witcher 3. Today, the ugly baby. We gotta talk to the Baron about his fucking troll child, apparently. So we'll do that eventually. So he's like, figure out how to get out of here. Haha! Okay, so. You guys do you. Trolled Harp. Oh, that's right, we're going back to Vizima, aren't we? It's been a while. Yeah, so the Bloody Baron, I'm curious to see if he is still hanging indisposed. What if he hung out for us the entire time, guys? It would be so kind of him. All right, so can I do world map? Velen. And God, it's been so long. And yeah.
His long search for Ciri led Geralt to conclude that Uma, the ugliest man alive and the victim of a curse, was the key to finding the young woman.
Man, it's not his fault that he's the ugliest man alive. I mean, the curse is probably his own doing, but it's just mean. Why would you say that about somebody? Like, holy shit, Dandelion, way to be a fucking dick. Ah, the weather is appropriately Velenish. Alright, the Baron's henchmen are all trolling about. Still. Man, it's been a while since we've been here. Holy shit, think about that. I should go back and see how many episodes it's been. It's been a while. Oh, we can actually talk to the smith and tell him we got his anvil, too. We're doing stuff. How novel. Hey, dwarf bro.
How may I assist you?
Went to Undvik a while ago. Found these.
Well, goose kicked me. These look like the real thing.
Because they are. Look at the markings. Authentic. How did you get them?
Long story. Might tell it someday, but right now I need that armor.
Harman Ep Grönekan, Lieutenant General of the Second Mounted Army. Welcome to our humble establishment. A true honor to host one of such renown. I've heard the General's a connoisseur and collector of armor.
This is true, and they call you a master of the craft.
All too kind, sir, truly.
I need a suit of armor, heavy, able to withstand piercing projectiles.
Piercing projectiles? Oh, bolts, you mean? Oh, that ain't easy. Needs a special alloy, tempering.
The new tools! We can do it! Stoke the fire, I'll ready the rest.
Bold, your worker. You allow her much.
You know how it is, General. Good help's hard to come by. We should go outside. There's business to discuss.
It's always the same. I've had enough.
Enough?
They treat me like I'm nobody. The menial labor. Truth is, the Nilfgaardian, the one Fergus is kissing up to, I'll have to craft his armor. Yours too, for that matter.
So what's Fergus do?
Horseshoes, nails, not much else he can do, seeing as he cocks up simple bungs. But in the end, they call him Master. No one'd ever think I could be a skilled armorer, a human and a woman to boot. A dwarven blacksmith, oh, that's another story.
If that's the case, stand your ground. Don't let him treat you like this.
I won't. Not anymore. He can craft the Nilfgaardian's armor himself. I'll make another suit, and we'll see which one's better. I need but one thing I can't get on my own. Would you help me?
Depends what it is.
To finish the armor, I'll need to harden it, quench it in a bath. Oil's what we usually use, but I want to use acid.
Kicky Moors and Arch Griffins spit acid.
Archgriffins. Draconic griffins, you mean? Baron's men came by a few days back, said they'd seen one north of Crow's Perch. It had killed some folk out there.
Bound to be a notice posted for the griffin anyway. Could kill two beasts with one stone. Fine, I'll see what I can do.
Bring me the acid and I'll prove I'm better than Fergus. And I'll craft armor for you, lots of it. The kind no other armorer can.
Alright, master armor. Get a gland acid from an arch griffin. Right north of town. Alright, we'll get onto that eventually. We have things that I want to do here. Is he still hanging? No. No, he's not. My disappointment knows no bounds. Where's his sergeant? Oh my god, navigation. Jesus. Main quest. Ugly baby. Where am I going? I demand only the ugliest of babies for my Witcher Let's Play. They've got a charisma that's above like a 3. I don't want them. So is he upstairs or down here? Hey.
Need to talk to you.
About?
Uma, gonna take him with me.
Believe you meant to say you've come to ask my permission to take. I am in charge now, so...
Not about to ask for anything. I'm telling you, you can try to stop me. But then I'll bring your enlightened reign to an end. An abrupt and premature end.
Think you got me shaking in my boots?
You sure as hell should be.
Fine. Cripple's not worth no blood. See the groom. He ought to be glad to give him up. Bugger's been eating from the feed bags. And a pleasant journey to you both.
Thank you kindly.
I love it when Geralt just stops taking people's shit. It's pretty great. Okay.
I'm taking Uma.
There ain't a...
Sergeant Hartle said I could.
Bring him back, though, won't you? Be awful dull without him.
No. Not about to bring him back. Open the door. Now. Hey, little guy. This here's Roach. She'll take us to Kaer Morhen. Well, come on. Like we got company. Nilfgaardian battle mounts. What do you want?
The Emperor's displeased with you.
Then he ought to ask somebody else for help.
The Emperor does not ask anyone for anything. You will ride with us to Vizima.
Sure about that?
Don't even try.
Fine. Lead the way.
and the Third Army will sweep in from the west to take Banglin.
If I may, Your Imperial Majesty, our spies report that the garrison at Banglin consists almost wholly of mercenaries.
Bribery, then?
We stand to lose exactly no men in battle.
And we stand to lose less time. Very well. Give the orders. Then set sail.
As you wish. At once!
Your Imperial Majesty, Yennefer.
I did not have you brought here for an exchange of courtesies. Report.
As you wish, Your Majesty. Ciri. Well, this man is the key to finding her.
I gave you 3 solid leads. Trails as fresh as morning dew. The aid of my spies and my court sorcerers. Yet in my daughter's stead, you bring me this monstrosity? I hope you have more to say, for your sake.
Listen, I'm looking for a needle in a haystack. A needle that at any moment can...
It's a difficult task, I know this. What of it? Listen to me. I rule the largest empire the world has ever known. I wage a war against the North, command men in tens of thousands, while at home the trade corporations and nobles seek to depose me. You cannot expect me to pity you the difficulty of your task.
This monstrosity might well be your daughter. Its body is the product of a curse. Someone hides inside it.
Can you lift this curse?
I've done a great deal of research, made inquiries, but to lift it, I would need to know the words used to cast it, and that...
Vafail Elen, Kedmil Fali, Gladiv Dorn Epteneid, Bandro Ithne Iyakus.
Dandelion told me. Ciri talked to him about it.
At last, you provide a pleasant surprise. Lady Yennefer, my question stands.
Yes. I believe I can. But I must...
The details do not interest me. Geralt, you've achieved precious little, yet admittedly more than the bumblers in my spy corps have. I give you half the promised reward. You will receive the other when you bring me Ciri.
Wouldn't count on that happening.
That was no request, it was an order, Geralt. And I advise you well, do not disobey me. This audience is over. Till the next.
Could have used some of that famous biting wit of yours. Where'd it disappear to? I mean, you were meek as a novice at Aretusa called into the dean's office.
I merely know when I can indulge my pride and when I must swallow it. Unlike some others, I know.
Ah, I see. So you show your claws to me because I'm a lowly witcher, but...
Do you really wish to do this now, Geralt? We can fight another time, in another place, where the walls have no ears.
So, how do we lift Uma's curse?
We must take him to Kaer Morhen. Oh, and Geralt, forgive me, but I'm unable to teleport you, Uma, and Roach, so...
Don't worry, we'll ride there. Never did like teleporting.
Take care of yourself.
Wait. Here, probably better if you keep it.
Of course. I'm off.
His long search for Ciri led Geralt to conclude that Uma, the ugliest man alive and the victim of a curse, was the key to finding the young woman. Geralt needed to lift the curse, so he took Uma to the home of the world's greatest specialists on dark spells, to the Witcher's fortress of Kaer Morhen.
forked tails this close to the fortress? Someone's been slacking off.
Quite a while.
Too long.
And your journey, how was it?
Calm, if you don't count the forked tail that flew over our heads a few miles back. Passenger got a little restless.
What have we here? Multiple deformities. Eyes, ears, nostrils, a hair, lip. And is this... Now, now, calm down. Yennefer was right on one count. Thing sure isn't pretty.
Don't look all that nice yourself. How'd you get so dirty?
Huh? Ah, this. I was mixing some lime for the mortar. Need to patch up the walls before they crumble.
A lot of work for one person. Lambert and Eskel not willing to help? Don't see the sense in it?
No. Yennefer found more important things for them to do.
Yen's here already?
And how?
You two argue?
Geralt, I understand she's a... Well, how do I put this? Emancipated, strong-willed woman. But do manners count for nothing? She teleports in... Not even a nice to see you. Jumps right into a, we've a curse to lift. There's this to do and that. So Eskel and Lambert get going. Then she went to the guest room to rearrange things. Through the bed, off the balcony.
Shame. That was a good bed.
Said the same myself. Solid oak frame, down mattress. Triss always said she... Now I see.
It's either that, or Yen really hates oak furniture. So what's Yen planning?
Wish I knew.
Mean she didn't tell you?
She told us what she needs to lift the curse, not what she plans to do with it, despite our asking.
She's up to something.
Glad you noticed.
So where is everyone?
Eskel's hunting forktails. Gotta nip that infestation in the bud. And since Yennefer needs to distill some ingredients from their organs, well, like they say, two birds, one stone. Lambert's still in the keep, preparing to venture into the mountains to enrich the phylactery with elemental power.
Mm-hmm. And Yen?
Assembling a megascope. Wanted my help, running around with some chirping contraption, searching for something. But I'm too old for that. Nonsense.
I should let her know I'm here.
If you say so, but don't go thinking she'll throw her arms around your neck.
All right. It feels weird being back in Kaer Morhen. I mean, I know we were here in, like, the tutorial and stuff, but... Or not the tutorial. Well, yeah, kind of the tutorial, like the very beginning of the game. Like, this is really the first time we've done much here since, like, the first game. Kinda... I don't know. It's like a little return home, I suppose. I suppose we will pester Yennefer first, since the others are all out and about. Just gotta figure out... where we're going. I'm sure I'm probably going in the entirely wrong way. I'm honestly not too particularly worried about it. Yeah. Why even let me get up? Oh, no, there's more. I was gonna say, why even let me get up here if there's nothing up here? They're just giving me opportunities to throw myself off of the terrain. I know it. nice looking, though. I mean, like, that right there? Oh, hey, frame rate. Come on, game. What are you doing? Like, this is some screenshot. Just fuck, man. This game looks really good. I'm never going to get over it. Just how nice this game is. Like, shit. And Geralt, get out of the way. Screenshots. You're taking it from me. Okay, we can't go. Oh no, yeah, we can. All right, there we go. All right. Well, now that we're here. Oh, this takes me. This is like the exact same layout as the first game. Like, through here's the kitchen. Yeah. Oh man. It looks a little different because, I mean, they're obviously like renovating. Aw, this is pretty cool. Yeah, and it goes down. Yeah, okay, we're ignoring Yennefer and I'm poking around. So is there still the tower back here? Ah, there totally is. I think this used to be up to Triss's room, right? Or is that where Yennefer is? I thought Triss's room was up here. Can we even go up here? Yeah! We woke up on that bed one time. Is there anything worth stealing in here? No. Aww, this is pretty cool. Seeing like all this stuff that it's been since the first game, since we've puttered about in these halls in any meaningful fashion. Ah, feels good coming home, I guess. Shit. Alright, well. Let's come up here. High action gameplay of stair climbing. Very good stuff.
God damn it, you piece of shit! Damned crystal!
You decide to blow us up?
Geralt, I'm sorry, but I'm in no mood for jests.
What's eating you?
Let me think. That was the third crystal to explode. It's been a week, and Lambert's still not done what I've asked. Vesemir spitefully insists on repairing the wall just beneath my window and starts hammering at the crack of dawn, while Eskil seems to have gone mushroom picking, not forktail hunting.
The guys. Well, they're not exactly happy with you.
Hmm. Why is that?
Because you aren't willing to say what you're planning. You're treating them like pages, not including them. Us, actually, because I feel that way too.
I shall explain everything, when the time is right. First, we must finish our preparations.
You got trust issues with us?
No. Actually, I fear you don't trust me. So, I'd rather keep certain things secret, for the time being.
Pretty tortured logic.
It may seem that way now, but you'll understand in time.
Heard about the bed. Really prefer to sleep on the floor? Wouldn't recommend it. That stone can get awfully chilly.
Frankly, I prefer a chill to bedding littered with red hair.
So upset about Triss, you gotta take it out on the furniture?
Would you prefer I take it out some other way? Geralt, I don't want to seem like a vindictive shrew, but that very bed is where you just happened to fuck a dear friend of mine. Yes, I know. You'd lost your memory. Whatever. Let us agree that I will refrain from scolding you while you will stop mentioning that stupid bed. Agreed?
Agreed.
Splendid. On to more pressing matters.
I love how these two bicker at each other. It's fucking great.
Fine. What do I do?
Firstly, help Eskel and Lambert. One was supposed to get me forktail spinal fluid. The other was to fortify the phylactery with elemental power. I've yet to see anything from either of them.
All right, I'll talk to them. Anything else?
Yes. There's one other trifling matter. As you saw, my megascope's acting up. In rather spectacular fashion. I'm certain there's an energy source nearby, generating disturbances, making the crystals malfunction. We must find it and neutralize it. Quickly. I must contact someone. It's urgent.
Who you plan to contact? Or is that a secret too?
No secret at all. Ida Emian. Remember her?
How could I forget? Member of the Lodge, Elven Sage.
Exactly. A sage. As the name suggests, she should know a great deal. I'd like to ask her for advice about Uma. Satisfied?
You're a sorceress, friends. The sage and not-so-sage. They've let me down before. But if we gotta, we gotta.
If only you'd been this cautious with all of them. But no matter. Thank you for your permission.
All right. How do I find the source?
Use this Potesta Quisitor.
Potesta Quisitor? Sounds fancy. Complicated.
Yet it's ever so simple. Grasp it firmly, move it around, and the louder it squeals, the closer you are.
Mm-hmm.
Spare me your juvenile wit, please. Well, what are you waiting for? Ah, one more thing.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Geralt.
I love the writing in this game so much. Dick jokes. Even witchers are not above. Even witchers are not above the low-hanging fruit. It's pretty great. Okay, well. Let us... Apparently it's like right out here. That's convenient. But I do think I'm going to go ahead and call an episode here. So as per usual, thank you folks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed yourselves, and I will see you all next time we're in Potesta Quisition. Fun. Until then.